CI durability, why exactly CI durability is required, and how we implement it. Going forward in the today's webinar, we will see what are the current trends in durability, what are the typical job roles, some case studies, and then how you can get into this domain. So starting with an introduction, going through the definition of durability. So durability is an ability of a product to remain functional to a set target of requirements based on the application of the product over its lifetime. So what does this imply? So whenever we design a product, it should meet some targets, and those targets it has to meet over its lifetime. That is durability. Durability talks about three subdomains: stiffness, strength, and fatigue. So stiffness is the degree to which an object resists deformation after being subjected to a load. Strength is a measure of how much a stress can be applied on a component before it deforms or fractures. And fatigue is a failure mechanism that involves cracking of materials or structural components due to cyclic or fluctuating stresses. I will explain you this in detail, but just understand about what is CAE part of this durability. So CAE is a computer-aided engineering, which means we use certain numerical codes and finite element analysis with use of a computer-aided codes and calculate the durability of a product. So we talked about the stiffness, strength, and fatigue. Let us consider a small problem of a deflection in a beam. So when this beam is subjected to a force F and it undergoes deflection of delta L, then stiffness can be expressed as the force upon the deformation. So it is the degree to which it resists its deformation on the subjected load. This stiffness can be in real life problems can be implemented where you have some deflection target for your product. Your product should not deform upon a particular target. Secondly, is strength. Strength can be expressed as the stresses, as we said. So your product should sometimes sustain a particular stress level. So when we have such targets, then it is a strength analysis. And when this same beam is subjected to multiple loading, as you can see in the diagram, and you need the beam to sustain a number of cyclic loading, that's the fatigue part of it. So stiffness would be expressed in terms of Newton per mm. Strength can be expressed in terms of stresses in megapascals, and fatigue can be expressed in number of cycles. Moving on to the leading softwares that are used in CAE durability. So as we discussed, there are two components of durability: strength and stiffness, and second is fatigue. So we have a convoy of software which deals with APA solver. So currently industry uses Abacus, Nastran, LS-DYNA, and ANSYS as leading software for finite element assessment. So what does this software offer us? So this software offers us static analysis. So the example of beam that we just saw is a static analysis. Then second one is dynamic analysis. Dynamic analysis, an example could be a closing event of a door where the inputs is not a load but a velocity which changes according to time. Thirdly, it deals with heat transfer.
Hello, sir. Sorry to interrupt you. Can you be a
Yeah.
bit louder, sir?
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So, okay, so we are talking about the capability. The thirdly, it deals with heat transfer. So, as we know, due to heat transfer in a vehicle, mostly you can say in the components adjoining to the engine compartment also, due to change in temperatures, there is expansion and compression of components, which can lead to thermal loads. So such type of example comes into heat transfer. Then we have vibration and buckling. Vibration is the evaluation of natural frequency of a component and other multiphysics capability. For fatigue, we have NPOD and FamePad. So these are fatigue calculators. So mostly the fatigue calculators work based on the FE solver. The major part of stress or strain calculation is done in FE analysis software. And then using these strains and stresses, we calculate fatigue in NPOD and FamePad. What are the industrial users? So mostly the CAE is used in automobile, heavy machinery such as Komatsu and commercial vehicles, all trucks and buses, aerospaces, power industries such as boiler, pressure vessels, electronics and medical equipment. So current trends, talking about the current trends, so let us understand what are the roles of CAE in engineering. So the most and important role of CAE is non-destructive virtual testing even before the prototype is built. So CAE is nothing but a virtual analysis of a product where we do not test a physical product. That gives us an benefit of cost wise and time wise. Secondly, reducing the time length of product. So the CAE, we can do it repeatedly and faster than the physical testing. So that's a benefit of CAE, catching problems early. When we do certain analysis, we do catch some abnormalities or problems in our product on an early stage rather than a customer using it and then catching the problem, preventing unnecessary design iterations, such as then helping to choose alternate material, that means product and cost. So sometimes on a certain product, mostly in plastics, we have a large number of materials which can choose from. So when we talk about polymers, the strain, meaning the Young's modulus, can be with using the glass filled fibers. So there you have a large number of materials to be chosen from. So when you perform a CAE analysis and you calculate the loads, you have that you can choose from different materials for your product. Then reducing the need of physical test, reducing cost of expected failures, validating the simulations and agree with reality. So validating the simulations is one of the most important points. So whenever we perform any simulation, that is in virtual world, and we need to gain confidence in our top management and designers to agree them that okay, whatever the virtual simulations that we are doing are correlating with the physical world scenario. So once these are validated, we can blindly believe on our virtual simulations. There will be obviously some gaps, and closing these gaps, we will have that confidence. and maximizing the product reliability and durability. So let us understand what are the state of art in their field. So on the top level, the CA durability is used for electrification as requirements in transportation and other industries. So nowadays the automobile industry has shifted its focus on electrification. So what does it mean in terms of CA durability? So suppose you have a vehicle which is your orthodox vehicle using an internal combustion engine, and the company is shifting to an electrification variant of the same model. So the engine would be replaced by a battery. It still has to fulfill all the targets. So here comes CA durability, which is a faster solution to make the modifications, validate those, and bring product in a very much faster rate to the market. Secondly, talking about the advanced features in are the multi-physics and co-simulations. So multi-physics is a domain where two or more physics are used. So for an example, if you want to simulate the noise of a closing of door, so noise will relate to and vibration or noise domain, and the closing of door that can be simulated as a durability domain. So when we combine both of these, it becomes a multi-physics problem. So the state of art companies are using this CA for the multi-physics simulation nowadays. The third point I mentioned is the vehicle dynamics and multi-body dynamics. So multi-body dynamics is also a very state-of-art technology being used nowadays. In multi-body dynamics, we generally acquire a road load data and then we apply it on the vehicle, where you can generate stresses from the load condition, road condition, and calculate fatigue. So this ensures that your vehicle will be running properly for its complete lifetime, say 10 years or 15 years, that is prescribed by the company. Third is optimized design solutions with AI machine learning techniques. So artificial intelligence and machine learning are the new tools that are being clubbed with CA durability. So when we find out an optimized design, we run a number of simulations which gives you an optimized product. So combining artificial intelligence and machine learning, we can get more faster optimized designs and better designs. Customization and automation of process efficiency. So automation is also the future. Mostly
hello sir.
Hello.
Yeah sir, voice is not audible, it's getting low sometimes. Can you be a bit louder sir?
Yeah, I'm holding the microphone here.
Yeah, your voice is getting low, very low sometimes from me, for me also, for the participants. Can you be a bit louder so that they can understand?
So now it is okay.
Yeah sir, you can just continue. If there is any same issue, I'll just let you know sir.
Okay. So I'm holding the mic at the same position, but just let me know if it goes down.
Yeah, sure, sir.
Okay, yeah. So we were on the automation. So automation means getting the repeated process, automating the repeated process to make all the overall process efficient and reliability and predictive analysis.